In this video, we're going to look at the coefficient of variation and what it can tell us about variation. I'm going to assume that if you're watching this, you already know what standard deviation is. So just as an example, suppose we hear that the standard deviation of an animal's weight is 5 pounds. Now remember, standard deviation means that on average, an animal's weight will vary, in this case by 5 pounds, from the mean. So my question is that a high variation or a low variation? Is 5 pounds a lot of variance? Well, you might be guessing from this picture that it sort of depends. If we imagine a 5 pound variance for a cat, that's a fairly significant amount of weight difference, whereas a 5 pound variance for or standard deviation for a hippo would not be so significant. Right, so this 5 pounds, of course, I just made up. This is not a real figure for either of these animals. But the point is that a particular standard deviation can mean different things for different populations. So for cats, just as an estimate, the average weight of a cat is about 9.5 pounds, so we could make that the mean. And a standard deviation for weight for cats is about 1.2 pounds. For hippos, average weight is approximately 3,500 pounds. And these are estimates, but the standard deviation would be somewhere around 200 pounds. So of course we could say that the standard deviation for a hippo is larger than the standard deviation for a cat. And that's not surprising because we would expect that hippos' weights would vary more relative to cats just since they're such different sizes. But does this really mean that hippos have a larger range of weights than cats do? We really want to know what do these differences mean, relatively speaking? And this is what coefficient of variation tells us. So the coefficient of variation is calculated by taking the standard deviation and dividing by the mean. So for a cat, we would take our standard deviation of 1.2, divide by our mean of 9.5, and we get 0.126316 approximately. And then we always want to take these and convert them to a percentage. So in this case, this would be 12.6%. So what that means is that the standard deviation for the weight of a cat is about 12.6% of a cat's weight. If we compare this to the hippo, right, we'll take our 200 pounds for our standard deviation divided by our mean, 3,500 pounds. You don't need to write the units here, they cancel anyway. And this comes out to 0.057143, or again, if we convert this to a percentage, right, by multiplying by 100, this would be 5.7%. So this is pretty interesting, even though obviously the hippo's weight varies more in terms of pounds. Relatively speaking, hippos have a much lower variation in weight than cats do. Cats vary by roughly, on average, 12%. Again, this is standard deviation, so some cats will have weights well above 12% higher, or maybe below. There will be some cats with weights that are exactly 9.5. But that average variance for cats is quite a bit higher than for hippos, relatively speaking. So the key point here is that the coefficient of variation is a way of measuring the relative variation. Right? So we can take a standard deviation and say, okay, what does that mean relatively speaking? Is that a lot of variation or a small amount of variation? If cats' weights varied by 200 pounds, if that was our standard deviation, that would be a crazy amount of variation. But these percentage measures are a good way to compare populations that have very different means, that have very different sizes, but you don't have to use them in comparing things. If we were just looking at one population or one sample, we could still look at the relative variation using this. All right, so to finish up, you should try this exercise here. We've got some data on the age and salary of CEOs from 60 top small companies. So compute the coefficient of variation for both age and for salary, and use those to determine which one has more variation. That's all for this video.